There's gotta be a landline in that office, man. I think we'll be all right.
Yeah, at least for a little while.
You just call somebody, get a little help, and we'll get out of here. Hey, it's me. Look, we really need to get out of New Jersey. Yeah, the things are heating up. We got like half the New Jersey mob after us. And a cemetery in Hoboken.
Here I was again, halfway down the world, and still looking at the bodies of women I was supposed to protect. Only difference now is, I didn't understand the language.
Gringo! Vá! Vá! Vá pra lá! Tranquilo! Tranquilo! Pode ficar tranquilo! Fica nessa parede, seu americano de merda! Que porra tá acontecendo aqui? Que merda tá acontecendo aqui?
Haven't you figured out? I don't speak your fucking language!
Seu gringo de merda! Cala a boca, seu gringo!
That's right, I may be a moron, but here's the thing. I ain't quite as dumb as I seem.
It was time to get out of there. Seemed like someone had decided to carry out some impromptu justice on the street life below. I'd failed Rodrigo and I'd failed Fabiana. In that awful nightclub, the stadium, the docks, I'd been given enough chances to make this right, and again I'd blown it. Perhaps this was my punishment from the fates. Keep reliving the same mistakes for all eternity. Danger of this starting to get too real. It was a goddamn war zone. I had to assume Giovanna and Marcella were out there somewhere. Maybe I still had a chance to get somebody in that family through the day in one piece. The place was swarming with cops, but they weren't there for me, as far as I could tell, and I'd blundered my way into enough clusterfucks for one day. If these fools could buy me some time, I might have a chance to get to Marcello and Giovanna before somebody put a bullet in their heads too. Giovanna and Marcella were still alive, but I didn't hold out much hope they'd stay that way for long. I'd already lost the ransom money, got the hostage killed, and I was only just getting started. This was turning into another fine example of private security work. These raids, rent-a-thugs in body armor sending a message to the poor that the cops are still in charge. When they hit the favelas, they came in hard and fast, was fair game, as I was about to find out.
Come on!
The odds of me getting out of there alive, let alone Giovanna and Marcello, were narrowing with every passing second. My body ached and my eyes burned. I needed something to straighten me out.